According to the St. Lucia National Youth Council, the event, which it considers to be its brainchild, was held under the auspices of the local government ministry for the island's 44th independence anniversary celebrations. The SLNYC says it wasn't given any explanation by the Independence Planning Committee as to why the decision was made, and the organization was left without a contribution to independence celebrations. Youth Minister Kenson Casimir, during Monday's pre-cabinet press briefing, revealed that the avenue for his assistance on the matter remained open, and he is saddened to learn about the situation only after the fact.
I thought it was very curious that those statements were being made, considering the tumultuous sort of level of activities that befell the NYC over the last 3 years. As the newly elected Minister of Youth Development and Sport, I made myself available to the NYC. I was the one who called for the first meeting after they were elected, not them, to sit at the table. And at that meeting, I made it abundantly clear that I, as the Minister of Youth, would be available for them whenever there were any areas of contention to sit at the table and discuss how we move forward. I had to find out about any sort of tug of war through the media. I checked my phone. There was no call from the NYC. There was no email from the NYC. There was no WhatsApp message from the NYC indicating that, hey, Minister, you have said and you have drew nigh to us to hear some of our issues. You've said and you've committed to us that we can sit at the table and discuss them. Let's have a discussion about the battle, really. This was not done.
Casimir questions the time frame for the allegations of, quote, corruption and the perceived tug of war between the two entities for the hosting of the event. He went on to explain that this year's National Baton Relay saw the inclusion of a wide cross-section of St. Lucian society.
I thought it was very curious that this was the first opportunity the NYC used to actually mention the word corruption. I thought it was curious that a baton relay or strides of unity was used as a method of putting out anything to do with corruption in St. Lucia, considering $7 million from the previous administration was taken for a vaccine that we've not recovered. That money could have gone into the works of the NYC. I did not hear any comment from them on these issues that we've been going through as a country. And I just thought it was curious that at the end of the day, that so many individuals that were part of the NYC before seem to have surreptitiously filtered their way through the NYC and, for lack of a better way of describing it, had their strings being pulled. We could have had discussion on, and we could have made a lot of progress on, because this government is really committed to listening to what young people have to say and making them as included in what we do as possible. And what we've seen with the battle relay is an inclusion of all sectors. And I think, as somebody who was a former youth proponent as well, youth development did not mean that only young people were involved. It meant that we were coming together as a country to get things done, even if it's from the youth movement. And what we've seen with the battle relay is that young people are involved, middle-aged people are involved, the elderly, persons from all sectors are involved.
Casimir says he will continue to reach out and better understand the gripes of the SLNYC, and says that his door remains open to lend assistance where necessary. For the DBS News World, Jason Darius reporting.